Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Fallout New Vegas, as brought to you by my amazing supporters over on Patreon. As per usual, we're just jumping on in here and we're gonna do side quests real quick. We're gonna have to tell these poor bastards that their leader was immolated by a jackass with a flamer. Let's see, where is he? Okay. Where's the old dude? Where is Ruby's husband? Is that? No, that's not him. That's not him. There you are.
Hey, youngster. Still hanging about Prim, huh?
Yeah, your deputy died in Bison Steve.
Well, I guess you're gonna have to find us a new lawman. I suggest talking to those NCR troopers across the bridge. I also overheard the Potter gangsters talking about some ex-sheriff on lockdown there.
Yep. We're going to go with the ex-sheriff because... The NCR. Like, that's the interesting thing about this game is that... When you kind of get down to it, the different factions, well, most of the major player factions, aren't as straightforward as they appear. Like, the NCR does what they do, but they're kind of assholes on occasion, too. Man, that encumbrance. All right, world map. Where is... I want to say it was here. The correctional facility is the prison. Yes. And we want to talk to our buddy, the sheriff, and let him know that a vacancy has opened in there, buddy.
Need to talk about something?
Yeah, how would you feel about becoming Prim's new sheriff?
Assuming an NCR pardon comes with the job, and it'd better. I also need to be able to do things my own way. Due process has its place, but sometimes it's just a waste of time. I'll need to know that I'm not going to end up right back in prison.
You have a deal.
All right, then. Guess I'll just make a quiet exit. No need for a goodbye party or anything.
Yep. As I steal his iguana on the stick because we're hungry. See, we're actually gonna eat some grilled mantis. There we go. We no longer have hunger sickness. Okay, so he's, I assume, teleported back there. And we can just, I think, go back. I don't think we actually have to get him a pardon. All right, so there's Nipton. Let's see. The outpost will be our next stop. Nipton is a silly place. Novac is where I want to be right now, but I don't know. I wonder if we can just... kind of juke over the mountains here to get up to Nipton, or to Novac. Because I just want to get to Novac for the shop that's there because I know they have energy weapons and I would really like to stock up on it, but knowing what I know about this game, it kind of has a route that they expect you to take, and if you try to deviate from that, they throw like death claws and cazadors and other just horrible things at you. Which we are not even remotely in any realm ready to take on. Okay. Because that is... Let's see. Okay, no, I was gonna say that's the Repcon facility, but that's not. The Repcon facility is like down here. That's probably the energy... place, the energy factory, where there's the dude that has a theoretical degree in theoretical physics. He's like one of the... He's an NPC that I see referenced a lot on random parts of the internet. Like, it's the only funny NPC in the game, which is a load of bullshit, as anybody who has ever trolled around with Raul knows. He is probably the funniest NPC in this game, and you can fucking bring him along with you on your adventures. So what's the bag? Is it minefields, death claws, radiation? Looking like radiation. Trespassers will be shot. I think this may be like a Brotherhood of Steel bunker up here. There's like a whole quest line with that. That's a huge pain in the ass that I'm probably going to be avoiding. But the more important question is, knowing what I know about these games. Oh, no, I was gonna say, I fully expect that we are gonna hit invisible walls. Because Oblivion does not like it when people break their narratives. Which, as I mentioned before, is one thing that Bethesda kind of has on them. Their games kind of... I've pissed something off, but I don't know what. Alright, it's over there. I don't know, whatever. I think it's an albino rad scorpion, or maybe a bark scorpion. He's so cute, thinking he can do stuff and things. Where are you, little buddy? You've got experience points. I actually want to be on this other side, so let's try that. Oh, naturally! Fuck. Naturally, Fallout's movement system fucking screws me, because that's... Oh my god. Pull your damn gun out, you ass. Jesus. Fallout's fucking movement system screws me, because heaven forbid you'd be able to, you know, have decent control over your character. One thing that I will maintain, they vastly improved in Fallout 4. That game plays a lot better than 3 and New Vegas do. I just don't think it's a good game. That's the problem. Alright. Let's see. I don't think we're probably going to be able to scrabble our way up there in that direction. I could try going through that pass, which I'm sure is probably just going to dead end us somewhere. Let's try this again. And I'm just going to quick save before we jump it this time. That way, if they decide to be like, oh, hey, you hit the space bar, but hashtag reasons you're not going to jump. Yeah. I'll just no clip my way over there. Cause like, this is totally a jump you can make right here. This is not, like, there you go. See, it's not even a remotely challenging jump. I'm just waiting. I'm waiting for the invisible walls. I was actually, when I was looking at mods for this, I was looking at one that removes the invisible walls. And then I'm like, eh, I don't know, probably not. But, at the same time, I begin to regret. Oh, come on now. Let's try this again. Oh, damn it, I was hoping I'd be able to, there we go, I was hoping I'd be able to get purchase on that ledge there. And we could, I just hit it at the wrong angle. All right. And the reason that I'm taking this route as opposed to going down through that valley is just in case there are death claws around here. I would much rather have the ability to evade them. Oh, here we are. All right, yeah, this is some invisible wall right here. And this is the shit, like this, immediate rage. Cause like this is them just screwing the player. It's like, why can't I get up there? There's nothing up there. But no, you can't because we're Obsidian and if you get off the tracks, we don't like you. Come on. Jump. Jump. Why are you not jumping? There you go. And, like, that is one thing that kind of drives me nuts about this game is just the freaking ever-present invisible walls. However, like, oh, yeah, there's one right here. Nope. What is it? TCL? Oh, look! We're fine, look at that. Yeah, we're walking. I'm gonna keep walking because screw these guys. Oh, hey, now we're down here and oh, look. Yeah, this is exactly what I thought it was over here. This is the little Brotherhood of Steel bunker here. Gene, I hear you say you're cheating. No, the developers are just shits and I'm not putting up with it. This is an area we should be able to get. All right, I'm actually going the wrong way. I don't want to be going this way, I'm going to be going this way. You should be able to get up here. The path is there. The developers are just being cheeky bastards about it and I'm not having it. And if you have a problem with that, there are, I'm sure, fair number of other Let's Players who will put up with their shit. And you can go find one of them. And I'm not even gonna complain about this because I'm absolutely certain I'm in a place that the player is not supposed to be in, so maybe not. Let's get over here. I don't know. Could you get up here? Oh, a target. The terrifying bark scorpion. Worth 9 experience points, possesses a sting capable of causing immediate death paralysis, and spontaneous breakdancing in its kin. Look at all those things down there. I don't know what they're doing. I dare say, well, maybe not. I say that our journey is going to come to an end, but I don't think so. Let's see, how's our map looking? We're getting there. We just essentially need to keep going east. And believe me, folks, like, I don't expect to be bumping into invisible walls too often, because generally I'm more than happy to stick to kind of the beaten path, I guess. It's just that, like, in areas where they're going to let me, like, you know, we should be able to just be up here. Like, they're being lazy by just blocking it off instead of creating a physical barrier to stop us. And bitched about that in Fallout New Vegas, but at least they had the sack that when you were in, like, when you were in DC, that they had, like, building rubble and stuff blocking the way. And so, can I shoot through this? I can. Can I grenade through it? I can. Ha ha! Totally worth it. All right, so this is, you know, obviously kind of worked up. Ah, there we go. Aha! Oh, seriously? God, you guys. This is ridiculous. Absurd. Stop being lazy asses. That's the thing, is like, I've always considered in games, like, especially something like this where it's open world and exploration. Yeah, this is the energy facility. Where, like, exploration is kind of tantamount to the game. Like, invisible walls, that is, like, just such a huge fuck you to the player. And it's like, it's not even hard to fix. Just put down some rocks. We're in fucking a desert. There are canyons everywhere. Throw down some rocks. I'm not gonna question it. I don't care. Like, just give me a realistic reason that I can't go in a direction. Don't be like, oh, there's an invisible wall here. Like, that's just fucking dumb. And there is no excuse for it. And yes, don't get me wrong. I know the whole story about them working on this game and that they were, like, crunched for time and stuff. And sure, you know, that's a reason, but no. Nope, 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 nope. Just throw down some rocks. Okay. Now, I want to be careful because I'm not necessarily worried about what we'll bump into out here. Because there is, I believe, some level scaling with this. Not to the extent of, like, a Fallout. This is Novac right here, by the way. Not to the extent of, like, an Elder Scrolls game. I said Fallout. That's wrong. But there is some level scaling. But still, there will be enemies out here that'll beat my ass quite handily. I just want to come here, shop, and we're gonna leave. Like, that's it. So, don't expect me to be, like, skipping a chunk of the map. I'm not going to. Because believe me, I want to play through this game. It's just, I wanted to come here without having to take the long way around. Instead, we just trolled through the mountains and I bitched for 13 minutes. There's also a doctor here, but I don't think we really need that. Also, one of the better companions can be gotten in this town, and I'm still unsure about whether or not I want to run around with companions. But he might be worth it. And that damn cowboy robot has followed us again, which we are purposefully avoiding, by the way. Like, believe me, I know where he is, I know how to talk to him. I'm just doing my damnedest to not. All right, hey Manny. Oh, that means helicopter. Hey.
Welcome to the Dinobite gift shop. My name's Cliff. If you're here for the T-Rex figurines, you're just in time. There's still a few left.
Oh, it's a good thing. What do you sell?
Well, there's T-Rex figurines, of course. That's our bread and butter. We also have an assortment of the Repcon factory souvenirs, rockets, things of that nature.
What about supplies? Guns? You sell any of that?
Guns? I guess I might have a few. Darn it, no one ever buys the T-Rexes.
It's because you've got a fucking cabinet full of them, you ass. What do you got for sale?
Sure thing. Have a look.
All right. He's got a lot of money and probably a lot of things that I'm going to want to buy. Gunrunners Alliance stuff. Let's see, where are they? You got, yes. Give me the energy cells. You got microfusion cells? Ooh, a laser rifle, a katana, glorious Nippon steel. I'm not even gonna. Panacea. A power fist. The rocket souvenirs, which we need a bunch of. A recharger, supercharger coil, which it does not look like he has any recharger pistols. Oh, that gun. That gun is best gun. Alas, we cannot get it. A Watts pistol recycler chip. These are really good. You can see it replenishes ammunition over time. That's not really how it works. What they do is, like, every so many shots, it gives you one back. So, like, they're nice, but they're not too crazy. An MF Hyperbreeder Alpha. This is a unique Watts pistol, I think. Laser pistol, as you can see, it's pretty lethal. It's also 12,000, 13,000 caps. Buy the laser rifle, though. Grenade rifle, oh my god! All of these things. I'll buy a doctor's bag. See, he's got a couple of the T-Rex souvenirs, you know, only 1,000 of them. Cowboy repeater is probably my favorite normal rifle in the game. A laser beam splitter. That might be worth looking into, but first, we gotta bring down the amount of money that we're giving him and have him giving us some. Look at that. Okay, let's see what else do I have. I'll keep like the casings and stuff, that doesn't really matter. Let's just flip through it like this. That incinerator can go. Switchblade can go, all of the varmint rifles. I'm keeping this laser pistol. Just in case. You never know. And don't need the Vault 21 jumpsuit either. Oh, let's see, miscellaneous. What kind of random trash am I running around with that I don't really need? Medical braces I'm gonna hold on to. Cigarettes can go. Pre-war money can go. Wonder glue can go. Ammo. Let's see, dump the flamer fuel and that will do it. All right, so I wanna check. Actually, I'm looking for a guy in a checker coat. Seen anyone like that?
Sure, but he didn't buy any souvenirs, if that's what you're wondering.
Dick!
Sounded like he didn't have his money with him. His friends seemed disappointed about it. Heck, I would be too if I found such a fine store and left my money elsewhere. Manny might know more about him. Thought he might have been friends with one or two of them. He's up in the dino mouth during the day.
Alright, take it easy. We just walked by Manny on our way out. Alright, so we have a rifle, which I want to check really quickly. Laser rifle. It's in kind of crappy repair. Alright, here we go. So, okay, so we can get the laser beam splitter, which gives us 30% extra damage. And this can actually get a scope, too. One of the mods that I'm running is Weapon Mods Extended, and it makes it so that every weapon in the game gets 3 mods. It wasn't like that initially, but it is now. I want to say it also extends to unique weapons.
Can I get you anything?
So that should make them a little bit more useful.
Sure,
like,
have a look.
There are some unique weapons that are just completely outclassed. I'm gonna buy this. I don't even care if it's 1,000 caps. That are just completely outclassed by modded up base weapons. Not that there's necessarily anything wrong with that, mind you. All right, so now we have a laser rifle. Look at that. And I'd shoot it, but we are kind of limited on ammo. Is he up here tonight? Yeah, this is Boone. Boone is a badass. Boone likes his hat. Boone can also join our party, and I'm conflicted about having him come along with me, because if he dies, I would be the saddest motherfucker in the world, and I don't want to babysit an NPC that badly. I'll think about it. Manny, come back. Manny, I need to talk to you. Don't you go in there yet.
What's going on, man?
I'm looking for a guy in a checkered coat.
Sure, I know him. What do you want with him?
We'll lie. He's a good friend of mine. I'm trying to help him out.
Oh, yeah? A good friend? If you say so, man. Well, listen, I can definitely help you find him, but I've got problems of my own. Maybe we can do a trade. You need my help. There's something I need, too.
Oh, my God. Yeah, Devon going full man whore. This is Fallout, Devon. He does this thing. You've had your needs neglected for far too long, haven't you? I can tell.
Yeah, everybody depends on you, you know? But they don't ask you about how you feel, what you worry about. There's something I like about you. You just seem really understanding. I was gonna ask you for a favor, but I'll just tell you what you wanna know. The guy you're looking for, Benny, he was traveling with some members from my old gang. They were going to Boulder City.
Alright, where's Boulder City?
It's straight up Route 93 from here. Just keep following the road north.
Any idea why they went that way?
No clue. I know Benny hadn't paid up yet. Maybe that was where they were supposed to get square.
Alright, that's all I needed to know.
Glad I could help. Hey, I know you've got no reason to help me out now, but you seem really nice. Could I at least tell you about the problem we've got here?
Sure. Why not? Maybe I can ease your mind.
See? I was right about you. Novac, it's home for me now. I want that to be for good. I like it here, and I've left too many homes behind. But the only resource we got here is junk. Without that, people wouldn't have anything to trade. They'd all have to leave. We get most of it up the road from the old rocket test site, but a bunch of ghouls showed up one day and took it over. We can't get in there now.
Well, what needs to be done?
Well, they gotta go, or this'll be a ghost town before long. Doesn't matter to me what you do. As long as the ghouls are out of there, that's good enough for me.
Alright, I'll see what I can do about it.
It'd mean a lot to me.
Alright, take it easy.
Yeah, see ya.
Good night, sweeper. Oh, damn it! I just wanted to see how much damage a headshot would do to him. I wasn't gonna kill him. Trust me. Anyways.
Howdy.
That's the Repcon facility, which is down there. We're not going to be doing that. Like I said, I meant it when I said I just came here to shop. We're going to be hoofing it down through all of this horribleness, which actually really isn't that bad. But there's adventure to be had, and I want to show you guys Nipton. Those of you who haven't played, it's... Let's just say it's a lively town. but for now, we're going to Prim, and I think I'm going to go ahead and call it. So, as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. Hope you had a good time, and I will see you all next time when the adventure continues. Until then.